we're coming up on another junkyard that used to be Ecology, and now it's something else. Don't know the name of it, or how much it is, entrance fee, or if you can even get in, or if it's just a dismantler. But it used to just be Ecology, and you could get in. I wonder if there is any Nissan-specific fields that are around here.
America Auto Dismantling, all makes and models, so we're going to see if they have Nissan.
So the guy wouldn't let me in, but guess what I found? On the low low. I had some dykes with me. Check out what I found. Pigtail! 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 Guy was also a dickhole. He wouldn't let me in, so that's why he got his G35 MAF sensor pigtail snagged upon, sucker. I wonder if that's a Honda. Wendy's Ghost Fries, a double stack, and a Frosty. Yum, yum. That's 1/8 inch MIP, 2 3/8 to 3/8 in FIP. By 1/4 inch in FIP to a 3/8 inch or 10 millimeter. And that's gonna be for the coolant fitting.
For the mechanical water temp.
There you go. It's a little janky, but
yeah,
it works.
Shitty. A little funny looking, but yeah, it works. As long as it doesn't get knocked around.
So we're back at the car. We bought a new boost controller, basically. This boost controller bleeds off pressure from the turbo to the wastegate, but it bleeds off pressure constantly. And this one is more like a restrictor valve. This one costs $15 at Home Depot, but it's more like a restrictor valve. So it won't bleed off pressure. Rather, it will restrict pressure coming from the turbo into the wastegate, and should see more consistent boost with it. So another problem that we've run into is the sending unit is really long. And so it'll fit in there, but we need an extension now. So we have a couple pieces here, but it's whether or not it'll work. So what we need is an extension that goes from here to there. So the mass airflow sensor is connected appropriately. It's a G35 pigtail connector. Hit it. Run it. So drill it out with a 3/8 first and then a 13/32. Then you end up with something that looks like this. Use an Actron scanner to scan for codes, and the only one that came up was the coolant temperature sensor, which is disconnected, and the MAF, of course, but the MAF is hooked up now, and so that those were the only two codes that showed up. There were a few more, right?
Yeah, just the coolant sensor, which is disconnected, and fuel pump? Fuel level.
So that's it, pretty much. So scanner's hooked up. Scanner wasn't working correctly a little while ago, but I don't know, it just started working correctly, so randomly out of the blue, so that's cool. And dyno testing and tuning is on Friday early in the morning, so we'll meet you at the dyno shop, ACG Automotive. So the way that this is set up using the G35 MAF pigtail is that brown goes to pink, yellow goes to blue, gray goes to, what does gray go to?
Gray goes to orange.
Gray goes to orange.
Red's black.
Red is black. Orange is yellow.
Yep.
So it's yellow, orange, red, gray, and brown for the QR25DE. And then pink, black, orange, yellow, and blue on the G35 pigtail. You guys on the Nissan forum, what is code P0102? I think it's MAF. It says mass or volume airflow, airflow circuit low. I think I've seen that before. P0102 mass airflow circuit. So here's what the connection for the coolant temperature sensor is going to look like. It's going to be hooked on the upper radiator hose by the thermostat, and it should actually be on the bottom hose on the return line after the radiator, but there's no way to take this apart and reconnect it because it's not electrical wire. It's like, I don't know, copper or whatever that's in here that gives it the reading. So we're just going to have to connect it up here, and the temperature will just read slightly higher than, you know, than it would if it's on the bottom radiator.
Lol, what? Yeah, man. What's up with this?